Britain, where they formed a voluntary corps known as the King's German Legion. And these Green Militia troops are known as Schutze. Austrians, Hungarians, the Prussians, the Russians, the Major, which is in the northwest of Spain, desperately trying to defend themselves. It's a rear guard action. These are troops left at the rear of the column. Their job is to slow down the attacks.
They got a few more than you.
Same size as the bore of the barrel, so you often have to hammer the bullet down the barrel, which takes some considerable time, and it wouldn't be British infantry was armed with what is commonly known as the brown Bess musket, and the French are armed with heavier, but a large was a boar, so the bullets, if they hit a Frenchman, would knock him dead. Whereas the French bullets were slightly lighter, and if you were hit by a French musket ball, you stood a chance of perhaps only receiving a wound. But we can now see the French pressing home their attack relentlessly. They know that if they can break this rear guard, the British will be defenceless in their port, and maybe they could capture a large British army. In fact, the last British army. So it's absolutely essential that Sir John Moore can recover this army and take it off the field. And we can now see some of the British troops forming column and retreating. But they're doing this in good order. Give them a round of applause, please, ladies and gentlemen. They are not fleeing, they are not rousing, they are retreating in good order, as professional British troops would do so. But we can see some British troops have been left on the field. They've literally been left. They know there's no chance for them. French engaging now in hand-to-hand combat. Pushing and shoving, bayonets fixed, and now the French grenadiers coming in, the mortars as well, and the British now just leaving the field in disorder. We see the riflemen on the far side leaving the field, and now the last of the British redcoats leaving the field. But they have given Sir John Moore valuable, precious time to load his troops onto the ships so that the army can escape intact and not, as Napoleon had intended, be destroyed at Corunna. So ladies and gentlemen, we have a victory here for the French, but it is not the complete victory that they needed. They have not destroyed the British army, they have not captured the port. So ladies and gentlemen, give a cheer for our French victors here today. Come on, you can do better than that. Hip hip! Give a cheer for the French, come on! Hip hip! Hooray, hip hip! Hip hip!
British army needed to be raised.
Volunteers, children.
The parliamentarians were not happy to vote large sums of money for the king. All they did under John Pym was put their demands to the king.
The king knew right
to see a set of heads to continue negotiating with Parliament. Yeah? He left London and raised his standard at Nottingham.
Lower up.
Okay, go on.
Take some pictures of it.
Down the rebellion in Ireland. But in fact, as we now the civil war would be over. Now the Londoners were not happy about the idea of their city being taken by the Royalists. The Royalists were now beginning to...
are now getting the worst of it. They're harried and attacked in the rear by Spanish guerrillas. And they have the British redcoats to their front. Not a particularly enviable situation, I'm sure you agree. But the French troops are disciplined. The French troops were well trained. Well,
battalion of heavy infantry, close order infantry, and have one company of light infantry. But these light infantry, they didn't wear green coats, they wore red coats like the rest of their battalion. And they were armed also with the brown vest musket like the rest of the red-coated troops. But we can see the British pushing the French in the centre with their skirmish green. And now the French tactic with close order infantry was to fight in column if they had enough men. But in this situation, they're pushed for numbers and it's 18 to 20 men deep by about perhaps 50 to 60 men wide. This would be very good for punching through the enemy's line, and in fact was a tactic that they use against the Austrians and the rush fire from British infantry and artillery. And this tactic proved successful again and again and again against the French. Last of all being used, as Wellington said, the French came on in the same old way and they were driven off in the same old way. Now, there's so few here today, they must fight in line. Fighting in a column gives you advantage in the close combat melee, bayonet, because of the depth of the unit. But a column makes an excellent target, and the British troops can continue in combat. Also, the British had superior quality gunpowder.
One of the problems with a musket is after you've... far side of the battlefield on the French line, you can see some troops in green uniforms. These are dismounted cavalry. Loaded, killing most of the crew. This was a danger for the gunners. Sometimes the guns would accidentally... But the French infantry wisely now deciding to retire.
Seconds.
The grenadiers in the centre there, giving up a volley and now retiring. The King's German Legion shoots him on the left hand side of the British line now advancing. King's German Legion were made up of Hanoverians who were in the service of the King. Hanover was occupied by the French. And about 20,000 Hanoverians came over to Britain and volunteered. They will not just surrender, they will continue fighting. I'm sure the British will offer surrender terms. Will the French accept?
I'm going to run for it.
Making their last stand in the centre as the 44th Battalion advances with the yellow facings. Now they go into the bayonet, ladies and gentlemen. A bit of the old cold steel. Some of the French troops asking for quarter. Some turning and running. And we see the French surrendering. He's handed a sword over. He's got his hands up in the air, ladies. And some of the French troops now running. And we have here a victory in Spain today, ladies and gentlemen. The Wellington's troops. British army. French pushed back right up to the Pyrenees. And then in the year 1814, the two allies under the Prussians and the Russians and the Austrians captured Paris.
You're going to do a last charge, aren't you?
Until the Napoleonic came back from Elba, and then the Battle of Waterloo was given to the officer. And so, ladies and gentlemen, as the Napoleonic troops march from the field, please give them one more round of applause for the Napoleonic Association. The next event